right there.
Oh, right there. Yeah, that's a snow. That's a wolf.
Oh yeah, sweet.
That's a wolf for sure.
Nice spot.
I remember the first time that I saw Mr. Blue. He was moving through Hayden Valley. I had never seen a wolf that looked like him before. My name is Ronan Donovan, and I'm a conservation photographer. My goal for this trip to Yellowstone is to look for the legacy of a very specific wolf, Mr. Blue. It'll be a thrill to see an animal that is part of that initial legacy, that lineage that was part of the founding population of Yellowstone. Mr. Blue was part of that legacy, and to find another wolf that looks like Mr. Blue would be an absolute thrill. He had this kind of steely blue, grayish coat color. I'm curious to find other wolves potentially in Yellowstone that are carrying on that lineage, that coat color. I still feel confident that the legacy of Mr. Blue, that his offspring, his genetics live on in this population. Every single animal is an individual, and they have these amazing, dramatic, intense, theatrical lives. Mr. Blue is one of those wolves. I was given an opportunity to photograph wolves in Yellowstone. And I, through a very special permit process with the park, was able to set up a remote camera, camera trap. So I just full on threw myself into that task and was struggling at it, not getting usable wolf images for better part of 6-7 months. But then Mr. Blue came through. And it has become one of my most favorite images. Mr. Blue, kind of mid-stride, staring right at the camera. I was given this chance and got lucky, and Mr. Blue allowed me to document his life in that way. Since Yellowstone's a tough place to be in winter, you kind of just have to prepare for anything, especially if you're gonna be out for multiple days. You just have to be ready, have your camp dialed in. Name of the game in Yellowstone is just to be well prepared. Wolves are perfectly adapted to this environment. So while I struggle in the winter with all my equipment and with the cold, when it's negative 30, the wolves are up and moving. They perfectly adapt to their environment. It's a very enviable lifestyle that they have, living alongside their family. It's an amazing thing to see, and it's something that I want to share with more people. We fear the things that we don't know. Getting to know the wolves better and getting to understand them means that there's less fear and a more authentic understanding of their lives. This is the hardest time in 25 years in wolf history of Yellowstone to be a wolf. This year, there were 25 Yellowstone wolves that were taken, a quarter of the entire population. Yellowstone wolves are at the lowest they've been in, I'd say, over 15 years. And that's because of human hunting. An entire pack of wolves that lived inside Yellowstone called the Phantom Lake Pack that was entirely eradicated, that was killed by hunters over the course of the winter. It's been a very different year for wolves in Montana and will remain so unless laws change or human attitude changes. I would love for people to understand that humans are animals and we came from the same landscape that every other animal has come from. I think it's important to feel a deeper connection to wilderness and wild spaces. I feel deeply connected to a larger purpose, to a larger community, the more that I immerse myself in wild spaces. And I think that that's a beautiful thing.